Regardless of the number system we use, our minds are drawn toward the recognition of patterns. Learning to count in base 10, in part, is learning to recognize the repeating pattern in the units and how this carries across to the tens and hundreds. After learning to count by ones, children will learn how to count by tens. The nice thing about tens in our own number system is that it's the same as counting by ones in the tens column, while the units column stays at zero. In learning to count by tens in this way, we also learn to recognize multiples of 10 as those numbers which have a zero as their last digit. A multiple of a whole number is the result of multiplying that number by whole numbers other than zero. Note that we are saying multiple of, so that this is a relationship between two numbers. A number can't be a multiple by itself, it has to be a multiple of another number. The term factor is used to refer to this relationship from the other direction. So a factor of a whole number is a number that can be multiplied by another whole number to produce that number. In recognizing that multiples of 10 always have a zero in the units position, we can hence also recognize that 10 is a factor of any of those numbers. As it turns out, the patterns for 5s and 2s are similar, in that when we look at the multiples of these numbers, we can recognize these cycles in the units column. This is because both 2 and 5 are factors of 10, and we're using a base 10 system. But there are also some interesting patterns when we look at other numbers. Let's have a look at 3. As we count by 3s, we get this repeating 3, 6, 9, 2, 5, 8, 1, 4, 7, 0. So a multiple of 3 can actually end in any digit, but it's not just a random sequence. Here's one way of unpacking this pattern. If you divide 3 into 10, you'll get 3 and 1 left over. So after we go 3, 6, 9, when we proceed into the tens, that 1 left over will mean these numbers will be exactly 1 less than they were before. But then we also have that 1 there in the tens column, so if we add the digits together, we'll get that same 3, 6, and 9 back. How about when we go into the 20s? Well, dividing 3 into 2 lots of 10 gives 2 lots of that 1 left over, and so now with 21, 24, and 27, again, adding the digits together gives us 3, 6, and 9. But then 3 does go perfectly into 30, and so now we get the 3, 6, 9 pattern back again. And into the 40s, that 1 left over idea can be carried through. And so all multiples of 3 will add together to make a multiple of 3. How about when we go into hundreds and thousands? Well, the same kind of thing happens. Again, when we divide 3 into 100, we get 1 left over. So we'll have 102, 105, 108 again, adding together to make 3, 6, and 9, and a similar thing will happen in the thousands. To me, it seems like a very unexpected thing that we should be able to add digits together in order to test for whether a multiplication relationship exists. But by looking a little deeper, we can see why it makes sense. And that's why mathematics is full of nice surprises just like this.